Rameshwaram Cafe's low-intensity blast in the Whitefield area of Bengaluru has left at least 9 individuals injured. Authorities have confirmed that it was improved explosive device or IED blast and a suspect has been identified. The police have identified a suspect who, in a seemingly calculated move, left behind a bag containing an improvised explosive device. The incident bears similarities to a blast reported in Mangaluru back in 2022. Karnataka Deputy Chief Minister D.K. Shivakumar addressed the media confirming the link between the two incidents.
I'm telling you, see, we are, the government is very much committed to come out with a clean, fair investigation. We have given free to the all the police authorities. CCB is investigating the matter. 7-8 groups has already been set up. They are on the job. They are trying to trace the culprit. We will know about it. We have left them free. But fortunately, I think no major incident has happened. But still, we doesn't want Bangalore, anyone to be scared. We will, the police will come out with a clean investigation, fair investigation, and we'll book the culprit.
So you said there's some links between Mangalore, Shimoga and this.
Yes, the blast seems to be in a similar way, which they have used, whatever the equipment they have used, look in the same way. So they are also looking at all angles. We can't see, this is a very big city, you can't do it. There are, see, in Mangalore also, when BJP government was there in Mangalore, Shivamogga, all these things has happened. In Parliament also, you know what happened in Parliament. So sometimes we can't blame everyone. Yes, definitely there will be this is a small, as a common man, he has walked inside with a bag in his shoulder, which we can't identify who is doing such type of criminal activities. But government is looking at all angles.
According to police officials, the materials used in the Rameshwaram Cafe blast are strikingly similar to those employed in the Mangaluru explosion. Both incidents involved the use of a bulk filament as a detonator, a digital timer and identical batteries. It's worth noting in the Mangaluru blast of 2022, the accused, Mohammed Sharif, accidentally triggered the IED in his bag during an auto ride. The police later discovered that Sharik was already a wanted criminal with two accomplices arrested in Shivamogga just a month earlier. The accused in the Rameshwaram Cafe blast, described as a 28 to 30 year old man, arrived by bus and ordered rava idli. However, he never finished his meal, leaving his bag near at a tree adjacent to the cafe before departing. The National Investigation Agency or NIA has joined the probe alongside Karnataka Police, responding to calls from the opposition BJP to involve the anti-terrorist agency in the investigation.
Subscribe to One India channel and never miss an update.